Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This week, we're going to be talking about Crazy Rich Asians, a movie that I loved. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. Here at The Review, I have a recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it, stay home and stream it, or skip it if I did not enjoy it. Now, personally, there aren't too many movies that I don't enjoy, and I will always do my best to not, like, keep it on if I didn't enjoy it. When I do enjoy a movie, buckle up, because I'm going to be talking about it for a bit. I loved this movie. It was so good. I went into it pretty blind, had seen the previews, wasn't super informed about what I was going to be seeing, kind of assumed it would be a movie about crazy rich Asians, which it definitely came through with being about. As I was leaving the theater, I recorded a quick clip, and we're going to watch that, and then I'll be right back. Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught. I just saw Crazy Rich Asians, and I loved it. I laughed, I cried. I will watch it again and many times for the rest of my life because I loved it. Here's hoping there's sequels. I will think some more about it and we'll talk about it on the review and the wedding. Also, so good. No doubt. We are going to be talking about that processional. Before we get to that, just a little bit more about the movies. Crazy Rich Asians is rated PG-13. It is 2 hours long, though, unlike some movies that are 2 hours long, this movie did not feel too long. If I had found out that this movie ran a tight 90 minutes, I would not have been super surprised because there isn't too much fat on this movie. I would say that they trimmed away everything other than what you need to enjoy the story and enjoy the setting. I thought that this movie did not drag at all in any place. I loved it. Can you tell? I really, really liked this movie very much. It came out on August 15th, which is a special day for me. That is me and my wife's wedding anniversary. That has nothing to do with Crazy Rich Asians, but one of my favorite days of the year. And it was directed by John M. Chu, who directed one of the best sequels of all time, a definitive sequel that is better than the original, Step Up to the Streets. If you haven't seen it, you should certainly treat yourself to one of the best dance movies ever, and also a definitive sequel that is better than the original, John M. Chu's Step Up to the Streets. Now, this movie is filled with pretty much every face that you could imagine being in this movie, and they were very upfront about that in the marketing for this movie. It is packed with every star of Asian descent that they could get into it, pretty much. And everybody has an opportunity to shine in full, very fleshed out characters. I really thought that they might just, like, I don't know, like, not give as much opportunity to some of the supporting cast to be as full of a character as sometimes does happen in movies. That was certainly not the case with Crazy Rich Asians. I felt that everyone that was on screen and given a name was given an opportunity to be a full character. Now, the main characters are phenomenal. The chemistry is real. I loved it. The characters are played by Constance Wu and Henry Golding, Nick and Rachel, and I loved it. Just a little bit about the plot of this movie. I will try do my best to avoid all major spoilers, but we are going to talk about the processional. I thought that going into this movie, it was pretty much just going to be about a woman meeting her potentially future in-laws. And while that is true, there is a little bit more to it. Rachel's character is a first-generation immigrant from China, and so she does feel like she knows the culture enough. And then her boyfriend, Nick, wants to take her back home to meet the family for a wedding. And she doesn't really realize what she's getting into until they get to the airport. And that's when she starts to put it together that Nick is wealthy. At least his family is. They reveal that in the trailer a little bit. And the hits just keep on coming. You find out that Nick's family, the Youngs, in the world of this movie, are responsible for a lot of the development in Singapore, which is one of the most expensive cities in the world. So obviously, not only do they have old money, they have a lot of it. That concept does be brought up a few times in the movie, the concept of old money versus new money. Actually, Awkwafina's character is used to illustrate the new money in town. I think that her character is just great. She's Peak Lin is her name. I loved her character. She is awesome. And yet again, a very full character, not just a caricature by any means. And I just thought it was super cool. And getting back to the Young family, his mother is played by Michelle Yeoh, who is in one of my favorite TV shows ever. It was a premium cable show called Strike Back. It's pretty much like an action movie every episode. If you've never seen Strike Back, it is all available on Cinemax. Definitely check it out. It's phenomenal. She was great in it, and she is great in this too. Now, early on in the movie, when all the characters are first meeting at a dinner party, one of the lines that stuck with me, and this is a very funny movie, just an offhand comment from Nick's mother, Eleanor, to him about how he needs a haircut. Now, I'm a hairstylist, and absolutely, Nick did not need a haircut in this movie. His hair looks impeccable. Actually, everyone in this movie is having a phenomenal hair day the entire time. Nico Santos, who is on one of my favorite shows, Superstore, is having one of the best hair days of all time in this movie. He looks phenomenal, impeccable at every single moment. Jimmy O. Yang is also on another one of my favorite TV shows. He plays Jin Yang on Silicon Valley. Another man just looking his best in this movie. The fashion is great. Obviously, they have the opportunity to dress everyone in a lot of luxury looks. And this whole movie, like it, similar to Step Up to the Streets, looks phenomenal the whole time. I did have to do some research because I wasn't too familiar with the skyline of Singapore, and they keep going back to this one building. It's the Marina Bay Sands. If you haven't seen it, look it up. It's one of the most different, I almost said weird. It does look weird looking buildings in the world. It is actually 355-story towers that have a 1 hectare, which is one soccer field connecting piece along the top. And it comes up again and again, and it just like goes to show this is a different part of the world that we don't see very much on film. I feel like a lot of times, anytime you see a modern Asian setting in film, it's, you know, like in Black Panther, we saw it, and it was where like kind of like the bad guys are in, I'm forgetting the exact one, but one of the Daniel Craig James Bond movies. Again, we see a modern Asian setting, but it's kind of where the villains are. I love that this movie just was showing us a different part of the world without it having to have a villainous aspect to it, or like kind of a mysterious aspect of it. I feel like this movie does a phenomenal job of showing us Singapore, showing us this cast without anyone having to, first of all, be the outright villain, which all too often happens with minority groups. And also showing us a part of the world that we never really get to see in a way that we never really get to see it. They go to a food court at one point, and like I feel like many white people have heard that some food markets have Michelin stars, and I think they showed us that and told us what we were seeing so that we would know what was happening as the audience. I thought it was super great. Like I was saying, this movie is just like absolutely jam-packed with many, many Asian actor and actresses. Ken Jeong is in this movie as Awkwafina's father. Love him. Obviously, all the Hangover movies are great, and Community was really good for a little bit. really liked most of Community. And pretty much what I want to get across is this movie was good. It left me feeling amped up. I was really ready to see sequels right away. I do think that we will get sequels. This is certainly part of the rom-com renaissance that's going on right now. A lot of those being on Netflix, available to stream right now. And I think it speaks to the audience in general that we are getting more of these rom-coms. We're ready to see movies that are a little bit of an escape, a little bit just like fun. Not really a villain so much in this movie. There will be conflict in a rom-com, but they just do a great job of just like making a movie. It's a popcorn movie. The theater was packed when I saw it. I was actually shocked that this movie, it feels weird to say, only made $25 million, but this movie made $25 million on its opening weekend, and it was a packed house. So I would be interested to see how it did in every part of the country, just to see, because in Burlington, the theater was packed. It was super good. Just before I get out of here, just like one other performance in this movie that I thought was phenomenal. Gemma Chan, who played Astrid, who is the main character, Nick's sister, was phenomenal. Again, a full actualized character. She was in Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, which I really enjoyed, especially upon rewatching. And she's going to be in the upcoming Marvel movie, Captain Marvel, Really excited to see that. Really excited to see some more of this universe. Hopefully there will be sequels. It's based on a book. There are sequels to the book. And before I get out of here, just like an honorable mention one more time, Jimmy O. Yang's character, Bernard Tai, one of my favorite characters in film this year. Definitely want to get him up there as an honorable mention for my year-end awards for one of my favorite performances. Absolutely want to remember that. I thought he was great. And also, Harry Shum Jr. is mentioned a lot for being in this movie. He's not in this movie. He's just in it very, very briefly at the end. So odd that they are billing him so high when it is so full of all these phenomenal performances. I loved this movie. I think that you will too. While it's still in theaters, I think it's absolutely worth the experience. Go and see Crazy Rich Asians. I loved it, and I think you will too. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.